This is Rapper News. Today we learn the difference between the kingdom of God and the kingdom of Christ, and that is Christ crucified, not Jesus of Nazareth, two different entities. The kingdom of God is in heaven. The kingdom of Christ, and that's Christ crucified, is of this world on this earth. What is this earth? This earth is hell. If you ask people who believe in God, where is hell? They will say it is right beneath us. So we are on what? Hell. When God's fire that is kindled in his anger come down, it will burn to the lowest part of hell. Where is that? Right here on this earth. So this earth is what? Hell. So when we were cast out of the garden, kicked out, us and Satan and all the Gentiles, we were cast down to hell, and we are sitting on top of hell right now, being given some time and respite to get it together before all of us enter into that great fire or enter into his kingdom. We're going to start with Matthew 6:10, and we're going to show you some things that you might not have saw because you didn't have a teacher that could teach it to you. Matthew 6:10, thy kingdom come. That means God's kingdom is coming. Thy will be done in earth as it is in heaven. Right? So, however you act in heaven is how you act on this earth, is what God is saying. Revelations 12:10 now. Christ crucifies kingdom. And I heard a loud voice saying in heaven, now is come, and that's come down, salvation and strength and the kingdom of our God, Satan, and the power of his Christ that came down to this earth. So if you read the whole testimony, you will see that baby Jesus Christ is coming down, Christ crucified, the bright morning star God, right? And the whole host of Satan and his angels, which is what? The devil and the Gentiles are coming down to earth. They're being cast out because the Gentiles were created before mankind, according to Genesis, and they had already established kingdoms there. Heaven and earth were joined together and partitioned. 1 Corinthians 6:10. Nor thieves, nor covetous, nor drunkards, nor revelers, nor extortioners shall enter into God's kingdom. They're not there. Again, listen very carefully because you've been word wizard. No thieves and no covetous, no drunkards, no revelers, no extortioners, no sinners is in God's kingdom. Let's see what's in Christ's kingdom to the right. Matthew 13:41. The Son of Man shall send forth his angels, the devil and his angels, and they shall gather out of his kingdom all things that offend. So offenders are in the kingdom of Christ crucified, and them which do iniquity. Two different kingdoms. One is light, one is darkness. One you can't enter in as a sinner. And this other one, he got all kind of sinners and offenders up in his. Let's look at that carefully. The Son of Man shall send forth his angels, and they shall gather out of his kingdom offenders and them who do iniquity. They're not here. They're over there. When this kingdom came down, that's Satan's kingdom, Christ crucified. So let's take some comparisons here. Daniel 7:13, I saw in the night vision, and behold, one like the Son of Man. If I say one like a black man, is he a black man? No, he's Abu. He's from India, right? He's not a black man considered as us, but he may look like us because of his skin may be dark at night, right? Anyway, one like the Son of Man. So you got Jesus of Nazareth, and then one like him came with the clouds of heaven and came to the Ancient of Days, came down to earth, and they brought him near before him, and there was given him dominion. Why? Because they did a bargain with God. Satan and the Gentiles, their heaven is on this earth. And then they all go to hell in the end. And glory and a kingdom that people and nations and languages should serve him. Right? His dominion is an everlasting dominion, but that's an eternal dominion in hell, which shall not pass away. You got to understand. Listen. Hell, which is this earth, is going to be thrown in the lake of fire. The devil is going to be thrown in the lake of fire, him and his kingdom. His kingdom is here on this earth. How is it going to decay and go away in hell when they're going to be in the everlasting flame? It's an everlasting kingdom. You get it? Which shall not pass away, and this kingdom that shall not be destroyed, because it's going to keep getting reanimated over and over and over again to be destroyed over and over again, but it ain't going to never die. John 17, 2. And thou hast given him power over all flesh, right? That he should give eternal life to as many as thou hast given him. Listen. And there was given him all people, nations, and languages. And power was given to who? Christ. Given him. By who? God. This devil is the same as this devil. Let's keep going. Revelation 13:7. And it was given unto him to make war with the saints. Right? And to overcome them. And power was given him over all kindred and tongues and nations. Again. Revelation 12:11. And they overcame him by the blood of the Lamb. Overcame who? Who was it talking about? Well, God cast down the Gentiles. And they said they overcame God by the blood of the Lamb. What does that mean? That means the beast was slain, like in Daniel's number 7. And his body was thrown to the fire, right? Or the flames. It's either 7 or 9. Right? Just like Jesus was cast into hell. But it ain't Jesus of Nazareth. It's Christ crucified. Mm-hmm. Starting to get a picture of it, huh? Those who study the scriptures know what I'm talking about. Those who haven't studied the scriptures is bewildered. Anyway, they overcame God. And so, and then it says, that, and they preferred not their lives unto death. They didn't give a damn if God killed them and threw them in hell. They were liberated from God when they got cast down to hell. That's how the Satans and the Gentiles looked at it. Again. They even put a story out that they freed Adam and Eve from God's oppression. That's how they look at the story. Let's keep going. Daniel 8:12. And a host was given him against the daily sacrifice and reason of transgression. And it cast down the truth to the ground, and it practiced and prospered. Practiced what? Transgression, sin. Right? If Christ is in you, the body is dead because of sin. John 10:28. I give them eternal life, and they will never perish. Right? No one can snatch them out of my hand. Right? Because a host was given it to him. No one can snatch them out because God gave them to him. These are the people destined to the fire. My Father who has given them to me is greater than all. Mm-hmm. Revelation 17:12, and the 10 horn which thou saw are 10 kings. Funny how the 10 horns was coming down with Christ and Mary in Revelation 12, huh? And then Jesus is supposed to be the what? The prince of the kings of the earth. Which means that what? You get it. He the devil. Which have received no kingdoms as yet, but receive power as kings 1 hour with the beast. John 17:22. And the glory which thou gave me, that's God giving Christ power, I have given them. They receive power as kings 1 hour with the beast. Who else received power? By Christ? Exactly. Christ is the beast. That they may be one, even as we are one. Revelation 13:4. And they worship the dragon, which gave power unto the beast. And they worship the beast, saying, who is like unto the beast? And who is able to make war with them? Revelation 17:14. They will make war against the Lamb, and the Lamb will triumph over them. Who can make war with the beast and win? Nobody. Revelation 12:12. Therefore rejoice, you heavens, and you who dwell in them. But woe to the earth and the sea, because the devil has gone down to you. Matthew 24:30. And then shall appear the sign of the Son of Man in heaven, and then shall all the tribes of the earth mourn. You got to remember, one Christ was born in Nazareth, and this other Greek mythology God came down. That's why the earth is mourning, because falsehood is coming down. Oppression with this falsehood. You know, the power of his crisis came down. Matthew 28:18. And Jesus came and spoke unto them, saying, all power is given unto me in heaven and on earth. Revelation 13:12. And he exercised all power of the first beast. See, all power was given. Would God lose his power and fell off his throne and died? I doubt that. All power was given by the devil and to his son, Jesus Christ, before him, and causes the earth and them which dwell there to worship the first beast, whose deadly wound was healed. Didn't he get stabbed in the side by the Roman soldier? And he came back, supposedly. Star God. The bright morning star. Daniel 7:26. But the judgment shall sit, and they shall take away his dominion to consume, to destroy it in the end. And the kingdom and dominion and the greatness of the kingdom under the whole heaven is what? Taken away in the end. 1 Corinthians, and this is the devil over here. And this is supposed to be Jesus over here. 1 Corinthians 15:24. Then the end will come when he hands over the kingdom to God the Father, after he has destroyed all dominion, authority, and power. So you're going to get this in the end, and this dominion and this power to be returned back to God in the end. So watch this. If Jesus Christ is coming in all authority and power in clouds, how's he doing that if he returned all the power to God? Y'all believing in the devil. Anybody who have any common sense, maybe a light turned on. You've been deceived and you know it. Right? Because how's the devil and Christ giving up power? How's the devil and Christ coming? How's the devil and Christ have a dominion and a kingdom on this earth? How's the devil and Christ exercising all power? All power is given to the first beast. All power is given unto me. Right? How is the earth in the devil's hands and Christ's hands at the same time? Because go out to all the peoples of the world and preach this false doctrine, right? But the real Christ only came to who? Lost sheep of the house of Israel. Revelation 26. Blessed and holy is he that is part of the first resurrection. So if you do a research in the New Testament, it will tell, Christ will tell you himself, and that's Christ crucified, I am the resurrection of the dead. On such, the second death has no power. What does it mean? When they was cast out to heaven, the Gentiles and Christ crucified, a.k.a. the dragon. Well, when they were restored to come back on the earth like locusts and to make war against the saints, that's called the first resurrection, if you didn't know. But they shall be priests of God and Christ, and shall reign with him 1,000 years. Revelation 23. And they cast him into the bottomless pit. Listen to the verse. You can go Google it. And who is there that will go down to the pit to raise Christ from the dead? Well, who is Christ? The devil. And shut him up and set a seal upon him that he should deceive the nation no more till the 1,000 years be fulfilled. That's them reigning with Christ 1,000 years in hell. Because some people asked recently, why would Christ come down and we would reign Christ for 1,000 years when we're supposed to be taken up in the clouds forever? How's both of that happening? Because this already happened. You're being deceived. See, they preaching the resurrection of the dead in the church, the baptism of the dead in the church. And that's what's happening. And they thinking that every time they talk about the dead, it's talking about Christ died on a cross. Mm-hmm. No, it's when the angel destroyed the beast and threw him down the hill and they was resurrected after 1,000 years. That's what it's talking about. When they was burning in the flame for 1,000 years. And that was liberation from the Most High God. That's them reigning. See, they didn't like their lives until death. They was destroyed. Notice that the 1,000 years, if you read the whole testimony, it's talking about Christ reigning and Satan reigning. Look. They shall reign with Christ 1,000 years. Revelations 20. And in the same breath, Revelations 20. You in there with the devil 1,000 years. You ain't think it's talking about the same one. Y'all got deceived. So again, we have two kingdoms. You should be a part of the kingdom that's coming. The real Christ, Jesus of Nazareth, preached God's kingdom come, God's will be done. The false Christ is preaching right here and right now. Joel Osteen, your best life now. His kingdom is already here. Right? This is Raptor News.